Hello friends, welcome to our Dr. Vet channel. I am Dr. P. R. Patel, Professor and Head Veterinary Medicine. In this presentation, we will see very important disease of a dog called canine parvovirus infection. Very important disease. It is a headache for the owner as well as the clinician. In part 1, we will study etiology, host, transmission and pathogenesis of important viral disease, canine parvovirus infection, part 1. First, we will see the etiology of canine parvovirus infection. Canine parvovirus 2 is the main cause of canine parvoviral infection. It is in short referred as CPV, canine parvovirus, or CPV2, or simply parvo. Now we call it as a parvo. The virus belongs to family Parvoviridae. This is the smallest virus and DNA virus. The word parvus means small. Parvo is highly contagious disease. That means it spread from dog to dog by contact. The parvo affects mainly dogs. The main manifestations are intestine and heart. In the intestine, it causes severe enteritis, gastroenteritis. In heart, it causes myocarditis. Morbidity rate is very high. It may reach to 90 to 100%. Mortality up to 10%. So this is very serious disease, dangerous disease. Virus destroyed by 2% sodium hydroxide solution or 2% formalin or 2% hypochlorite. For a clinician, this is important to make the disinfection of premises or disinfection at the clinics in the face of outbreak. Host affected by parvo. There is wide variety of hosts. Cattle, pigs, dogs, cats, man, rat and kitten. And of this, highly susceptible species is dog. And highly susceptible breed among the dog is Doberman and Labrador. They are highly susceptible. Disease is widely prevalent in India. In all states it is observed. The felines are susceptible to panleukopenia virus. It is a different strain of this parvovirus. Transmission of parvo. Canine parvovirus is highly contagious disease. The dogs become infected through very important route, oral contact with CPV2 virus in feces. When dog come in oral contact directly with the feces of infected dog get the infection. Direct oral contact with infected soil with feces. Direct oral contact with the fomites with feces. Or direct contact, oral contact with the excretion of infected dog with parvo cause the disease. So disease is highly contagious. The disease spread from dog to dog by direct or indirect contact with feces that we already seen. Remember clinician here, the virus excreted large quantities in feces of the affected dog. So this is the important source of infection for the other animals, for the other dogs. Transmission continue here. The infection spread very fast where there is large aggregation of dogs, large gathering of dogs, especially at clinics, important for a clinician. At clinics, the infected dogs come and it seeds the infection in the clinics. Other dogs are also coming, other dogs get the infection. At pet shop also, frequently the dogs are coming and going. Large breeding places of the dog, these places spread the disease. Friend, remember, virus seed in the feces, in a very short time after infection, 3 to 4 days following the infection, and it excretes the virus for up to 3 weeks. This is a potential source of infection. The infected dog afterwards may remain as an asymptomatic carrier and shed the virus periodically during the lifetime. For a clinician, pathogenesis of the parvo is very much important. To know the clinical findings, to understand the clinical findings, to provide the diagnosis, and to provide the treatment, understanding the pathogenesis is very important. Maternal parvovirus antibodies protect the pup during the early life because the pup takes the colostrum. Colostrum contains antibody from mother. It protects the pup. The virus has got affinity for lymphocytes and lymphatic system. Following the ingestion of virus, the virus replicates in the lymphoid tissue of the throat, and from throat it spreads to bloodstream and cause a condition viremia. Means the virus spread all over the body. Because the virus attack on lymphatic system, virus cause immunosuppression. There is leukopenia initially. Continuation of pathogenesis. Virus attacked rapidly dividing cells. Remember important part. Virus attacked the body cells which are rapidly dividing, such as lymph node, intestinal crypts, and bone marrow. These viruses attack these places because the cells of these places are rapidly dividing. And because of this attack on the rapidly dividing cells, young growing dogs are more victimized. Why young growings are more victimized? Because they are growing very fast. Their body cells dividing very fast. And virus attack young growing dogs because their cells are rapidly dividing. There is a depletion of lymphocytes in the lymph nodes. There is necrosis and destruction of the intestinal crypts. Virus invades the vascular endothelium, germinal layer of the cerebellum, liver cells, and fetal tissues. Even it infects the fetus. So when the fetus comes out after birth, the pup may suffer from the disease. The virus is mainly attacked and found in two organs. One is the intestine and heart. and this forms the group of symptoms. Virus present in intestinal epithelium causing enteritis, and cardiac muscles causing myocarditis. And this makes a syndrome of parvovirus infection. Continue the pathogenesis. We have already seen that virus attack intestine present in intestinal Krebs epithelium. So there is severe gastroenteritis, severe diarrhea with blood, and it causes fast dehydration. Because of this severe damage in the intestine, blood and protein leak into the intestine. That leads to anemia and loss of protein. Remember, clinician, for the treatment, clinician has to provide treatment of anemia, replace the loss of protein. In the intestine, there are many anaerobic bacteria normally present. They cross the bloodstream, enter into blood, produce bacteremia, and finally leading to sepsis. This sepsis is a dangerous condition. There is bacteremia, septicemia, results endotoxemia. The case become more and more worse. Bacteria get lodged into the myocardium, bacterial myocarditis, and the whole body is flooded with virus and bacteria, septicemia, toxemia. And this leads to a syndrome, very serious syndrome, called as systemic inflammatory response. It is called as SIRS. SIRS is commonly observed in serious condition. Systemic inflammatory response syndrome, a group of symptoms develop. This is very, very serious condition. Chances of recovery is almost nil when there is SIRS. Continue with the pathogenesis. Virus invade intestine. Virus invade cardiac muscle. It produces myocarditis. Myocarditis due to two reasons. This parvoviral myocarditis and bacterial myocarditis. And this results into heart failure. The white blood cells level decreased. The dog become exhausted. Very young animals have a very less survival rates. And when heart is affected, heart failure, there is death due to two reasons. Because of the shock, due to severe dehydration, and heart failure. Death is due to two reasons, severe dehydration and heart failure. That causes shock and death. Friends, now you have observed the pathogenesis, etiology, and other parts, transmission. It will help you in understanding the clinical findings, providing the diagnosis, providing the treatment and prognosis. Share this information to veterinary and veterinary students. To progress the channel, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much for observing this video.